Hi, hello. Today with us here is Dr. Indira Kundiru, all the way from Hyderabad, India. And she has been here with us in UMS for the past 5 days, holding a workshop concerning blended learning. And she's here actually to train our pioneer group of mentors in blended learning. So, welcome, Dr. Indira. And we'll let you to introduce yourself very briefly.
Hello, myself, Indira Koneru from ICFAI Business School. I manage the e-learning department over there. And I administer Moodle for 9 IBS campuses, Professor Fong. And I train our faculty members, not only our faculty members, I train faculty members across India in various academic and research institutions on e-learning, including Moodle, blended learning, open educational resources, e-assessment, etc. And as a consultant of Commonwealth of Learning, I also undertake consultancy projects on Moodle-enabled blended learning.
Dr. Indira, from your experience as a consultant to Commonwealth of Learning and carrying out so many workshops, could you describe to us what do you mean by e-learning?
Okay. We use e-learning as an umbrella term for many variant terms. Say, for example, ICT-enabled learning, computer-aided learning, web-based learning, online learning, blended learning, etc. And we generally define e-learning in terms of technology, that is, using electronic and communication technology for teaching and learning. But I look at e-learning in pedagogical perspective.
Yes.
Yeah, say, for example, if I look at the E in e-learning as engagement, enhancement, extended, empowerment, etc. So, extended means we can extend student learning beyond the classroom. That is one of the best advantages of e-learning. And using these technology-enabled learning, we can engage students in a variety of learning modes. And also, we can empower the students in choosing learning from any time, anywhere, using any device, in any mode, and also in any path. Generally, in face-to-face teaching, we can address students through only one mode. So, whereas coming to e-learning, so we can enhance student learning experience through multimedia. So, e-learning, so we need to blend all these E's. Then only we can call it as a true blended learning.
Yes, yes.
That is important, yes.
Thank you, Dr. Indira. Indeed, I follow your philosophy, and that is pedagogy must come first,
yes, yes,
technology
yes,
second.
Yes, yes, yes.
So we can design and develop pedagogically sound online courses using technology. Technology we need to consider as an enabler or a tool.
Exactly.
That's it.
Thank you, Dr. Indira.
Yeah.
The next question.
Yeah.
Dr. Indira, what are the benefits of blended learning to lecturers, to teachers?
Yeah, generally when we talk about blended learning, first thing we say is flexible learning. But through all these consultancy projects of Commonwealth of Learning, what I observed is it offers flexible teaching opportunities to faculty.
Yes.
So, three of my trainees, they told me they could use this blended learning platform, that is Moodle platform, when they were on sick leave, when they went for their PhD work.
Yes.
So, and one faculty member met with an accident.
Oh.
So, this using this technology, they could assign some activities to students and they could upload resources from their home and from their PhD institution also. So, that is the first advantage. And the second advantage is they can enhance student learning experience through multimedia content. And teachers can engage students in a variety of learning, say, for example, individual learning, group learning, collaborative learning, social learning, and all these. And one more important advantage to teachers is they can accommodate multiple learning styles. That is very important.
So many benefits to teachers selection.
Yes, yes, yes.
So everybody must really jump on board.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you. The next question is concerning what are the benefits of blended learning to students?
So when we come to the student's perspective, we should also have this mind in the multi nature of blended learning.
Yes.
So it's a multi in mode of learning, multi in accessing the content in a variety of media, that is multimedia.
Yes.
So and getting themselves, say for example, guidance not only from teachers, from peer group also they can learn. So this multi and various coming to communication also online. Generally, we consider communication as either one to one or one to many. Whereas this online platform through Moodle enabled blended learning, we can have multiple to multiple. So once a teacher creates something for one student or multiple students, they themselves start interacting. So they communicate among themselves. And also multiple ways of getting guidance from either teacher or peers or anyone else who is active on the course.
Yes.
So
indeed, our millennial students
require
this kind of approaches
in
teaching and learning.
Yes, yes.
Blended learning is able to support it.
Yes.
These students, we call them as digital natives.
Yes.
They prefer to use digital tools in everyday life. So why can't in their learning and development?
Yes, correct. Dr. Indira, what are the challenges that institutions face in planning through implementation of blended learning from the experience?
Generally, the first and the foremost issue any academic institution faces is change management.
Yes.
So that is the biggest challenge for the management.
Yes.
And the second one is creating a shared understanding among all the stakeholders.
Yes.
So generally, they fail to, the reason for this could be institutions, they don't involve their stakeholders starting from the planning stage or pre-planning stage.
Yes.
So these two are the biggest challenges. So managing the change and creating a shared understanding among the stakeholders.
And Dr. Indira, how could we actually address these challenges?
So we need, say for example, you have organized a workshop. So we need to first make them familiarized with what is blended learning. And
yes.
They themselves should also understand the benefits of blended learning,
yes,
not only for themselves, for the students also. That is important.
Yes.
So I have seen teachers who have understood this from students' perspective, their adoption rate is always high. So that is important. And another one is we need to create a mechanism to provide timely support,
yes,
to the faculty members in redesigning their courses. That is very important. That's what we have done as a pre-planning activity. We asked all the faculty members to submit their blended course design.
Yes.
Now they have become the learning designers.
Yes.
Uh-huh. And we should also provide them the support in the transit from traditional to blended learning.
Yes.
Yeah, that is also important. And we should also build a community of practice. That is very important. So then only we can take it to the next level.
Yes. Can you please define what you mean by community of practitioners?
So when we create an atmosphere where all these blended learning practitioners or teachers come together for a common goal,
mm-hmm,
and meet at frequent times and share their knowledge and expertise and showcase their innovative ideas in using, say, for example, it can be Moodle or it can be any other tools, in improving student learning outcome or in engaging students, and encouraging them to participate in various continuous professional development programs so that they can become the mentors and they can engage or motivate other mentees, or so that this is the way they can build a community across the university. that is very important. For that, we need to provide a platform, and we need to bring in not only the teachers, we need to bring into this community the academic leaders as well as the professional and technical team also. That is also important. We should consider it's a collaborative work. So, this building this community of practice improves their ability to perform not independently, cooperatively and collaboratively. That is important.
Thank you. So, Dr. Indira, for community of practitioners, I understand that you will also be following up with this group of lecturers. So, how important is the work of facilitator here?
Yeah, actually, now teachers need to transform themselves into starting from learning designer, or in general terms we call instructional designers, then facilitators, then teaching and learning analytics. That is also important. So once I design a course with needed learning outcomes, aligning all my assessments with learning outcomes and aligning my resources, then comes the role of online facilitation. Mm-hmm. Online facilitation is nothing but how effectively we engage students in learning interactions, how effectively we encourage them to participate in the online environment. We should not consider them as students or learners. We should consider them as participants. So then only we can encourage them to participate in collaborative learning. So they should also, they themselves can also transform or take up multiple roles, not only as a learner, they can mentor their peers. Peer learning always works. That is very important. So as a facilitator, a teacher should build an online community. That is very important.
Dr. Indira, in the past 5 days, I have also observed you, and I find you to be someone who is very knowledgeable, very skillful, and you're more than willing to share and even to inject your passion and enthusiasm into each and every one of us. For this, we want to say thank you to you, Dr. Indira.
Yeah. Thanks for this wonderful opportunity at UMS.
Yes. I would like also to thank the Commonwealth of Learning for supporting us, and especially to bring Dr. Indira Kangiru to support our smart e-learning agenda. Thank you so much.
Pleasure is mine.